When you think of mass extinctions, you probably think dinosaurs, which, I mean, that's fair, because, you know, dinosaurs. But the greatest extinction event of all time wasn't about the dinosaurs at all. About 250 million years ago, something caused even more species to die out, an event called the End-Permian extinction, also known by its much cheerier name, the Great Dying. The Great Dying took out 96% of marine species and 70% of all land animals. Yeah. Scientists have been searching for the exact cause of this mysterious mass extinction for decades, but most scenarios that they've come up with have been, well, less than satisfying, we'll say. However, a researcher at UC Berkeley is on the case, and he might be onto something. The most convincing theory so far involves the large-scale volcanism of the Siberian traps that happened around the same time as the End-Permian extinction. For those, by the way, playing the home game, that's at the end of the Permian era. The eruptions exploded 300,000 years before the End-Permian extinction, but were active for hundreds of thousands of years even after. They oozed lava and they just spewed ash all over the place. This would have caused a whole host of issues, like global warming and localized acid rain. But how did volcanoes in Siberia manage to wipe out life across the whole planet? To add to the mystery, the End-Permian fossil record shows that a global decline of forests at this time was coupled with mutated pollen. Something was making it impossible for plants to reproduce. It's been proposed that the volcanic gases from the Siberian traps could have severely compromised Earth's ozone layer, exposing life on Earth to extremely high levels of UVB radiation. Scientists think that this could have damaged the plants, potentially destroying the food chain from the bottom up. This is where UC Berkeley researcher Jeffrey Benka comes in. To test this theory, he took mini pine trees and he put them inside an extinction chamber, where they were exposed to extreme amounts of UVB radiation, akin to what would have been experienced before the Great Dying. Lo and behold, the trees made malformed pollen and became sterile. What's even crazier, though, is four of the five greatest extinctions on Earth, including the dinosaurs, were accompanied by large-scale volcanic events, which are often associated with warming global temperatures, acid rain, and you guessed it, ozone layer depletion. It's a little too early to say if this new finding helps explain other extinctions, but it is kind of crazy that Earth's worst extinctions weren't caused by giant asteroids or hellfires, but good old-fashioned climate change and ozone depletion, ain't it? If we keep at it, maybe we'll just bump the Great Dying out of first place. Do you think we could get a trophy for that? Oh. Thank you. If you're still worried about the ozone layer, you might want to watch this video about how scientists stood up to power and saved it. By the way, while researching this, we found that those volcanic eruptions in Siberia oozed enough material to cover a region the size of the United States in kilometer-deep magma. Cool. Thanks for watching.